So you are shopping for a new CPU and you want it to have 6, 8, 10, 12 cores. But wait. Hold on. The first thing to figure out is how many CPU cores you use now for your most intense video games or video editing apps. So that way, the multi-core CPU you get is not just for bragging rights, but rather, it's the exact CPU you need. Alright, as we know, we get straight to the point. The main way to do this is by using the Task Manager. And to open it, you're going to right-click an empty spot from the taskbar and then select Task Manager. And now click the Performance tab and then click the CPU section. By default, you should see this view with the name of your current processor on top. Now, this current view shows you the overall usage of your CPU as a whole, but it does not tell you how each individual core is being used. To do that, you're going to right-click anywhere in this area, and then you're going to hover the cursor to Change Graph 2, and then select Logical Processors. And bam! Look what we have here. Okay, so what do all of these boxes mean? Well, they represent your CPU cores. If you go to the bottom, it gives you more info. As you can see, in my case, for the Intel Core i7-4790, it has a total of 4 CPU cores and 8 logical processors. Now, logical processors, as discussed in the last video, has to do with the concept of hyperthreading, where one CPU core behaves like 2 CPU cores. So this is why, in my case, instead of showing 4 boxes for 4 CPU cores, it shows a total of 8. If you don't have hyperthreading but have a 4-core CPU, you'd see exactly 4 boxes. You have a 6-core CPU, you see exactly 6 boxes. But if you have hyperthreading, you see twice the amount of boxes as your cores. Alright, now to the fun part, let's start testing and let's see how each app uses these cores differently. The first app I'm going to use is Adobe Illustrator. And I'm going to open a very big vector file. And I'm going to convert that file into a regular image. I'm going to rasterize it. And this is going to use quite a bit of resources because it has a resolution of 15,360 by 8,640. Now let's rasterize it and see how it will show up in each individual CPU core from the Task Manager. Now, when you are using the Task Manager to monitor how many CPU cores an app is using, pay attention to the last part or the end of the graphs. After about 5 seconds, you will start seeing the differences in usage. So after about 20 to 30 seconds, you should have a pretty good idea of how many CPU cores that app uses. So as you can see, in my case here, Adobe Illustrator primarily uses the second CPU core. With this information, now we can make more reasonable buying choices. Let's say for example, you primarily use your computer for Adobe Illustrator. And then you end up buying a computer with even more CPU cores. Will that necessarily help your performance? Maybe, but not by much. For example, if you have a standard mechanical hard drive or not enough RAM, perhaps getting an SSD or even more RAM would really help you. Alright, now let's take things even further. Let's render a video using Adobe After Effects. Okay, now let me add it to the Adobe Media Encoder queue. And now let me start encoding. Alright, here are the results. As you can see, for the most part, Adobe After Effects is using pretty much all of the processor cores. And that makes sense because encoding and rendering really depends on the CPU. So what can we learn from all of this? Clearly, it's not all about the CPU cores. It depends on what you're doing. But of course, you cannot go wrong if you get a decent high-end processor. If you have any ideas or any suggestions when buying a new CPU, please post them on the comments below. Definitely for more easy, simple, straightforward tech tutorials like this, please subscribe and thanks for watching.